My name is Al Robertson. If after this video you decide you want to make a change, you want to build up some healthy habits, change your lifestyle bit by bit by bit to a healthier version, escape morbid obesity, try to live a long, happy, healthy life, and are having trouble with your eating behaviors, we have coaching at DamnCollective.com. We have a few slots open, so please do check that out at the link below or go to DamnCollective.com after this is done and pick up the coaching you would like or message me, whatever. But we have a few slots open. They'll probably go quickly over the course of the next couple of days, so please do check that out. I got this picture on social media today, and I wanted to go over it because it's sad, scary, all sorts of things all in one. It's this lady daring fat, and she squatted down in a position where I don't believe she could get up from without serious pain or help. I'm not saying that to be mean. I'm saying it to be truthful. I don't know where we've gotten to the point where saying truthful stuff can somehow make you villainous. If me stating that obesity is terrible for your health, if that upsets you, you got some work to do, because facts are facts and truth is truth. If me stating to you that the woman in that picture cannot possibly claim to be healthy, even if she claims metabolic healthy, she's not healthy because of how obesity treats your body. If that makes you uncomfortable, you've got work to do. Maybe do a little bit of fucking research. What's happening in this woman's body right now? This woman is super morbidly obese. So as fat cells accumulate in this woman's body, in your body, in anybody's body, old fat cells get choked out and die. Because when you're super morbidly obese, your fat cells get so big and accumulate so much that they choke out other fat cells. So as that other old fat cell dies, and don't worry about it, super morbidly obese people are adding fat cells faster than they die, obviously. So what happens with that is as the person loses a fat cell, not because the energy was dispersed, just because it got choked the fuck out by the other fat cells, it releases all sorts of crazy shit into your body, like TNFA, and it sounds so nice, TNFA. Oh, how bad could it be? It's TNFA. It's tumor necrosis factor alpha. It causes cancer. Or it's interleukin-6, IL-6. Oh, it releases IL-6. What possible damage could that be? It leads to rheumatoid arthritis, myocarditis, all sorts of other inflammatory issues, type 2 diabetes. This woman is in a chronic state of serious inflammation. She is in a chronic state of immune response, of inflamed immune response, because her body is morbidly obese because she's eating too much fucking food for how much she is moving. This is not brave of her. This is not, she is not the person that we need to work on to accept this shit. We need to work on helping her accept the fact that she needs help and should get some counseling and should get some fucking health advice. We as a society need to accept that shit. I understand that nobody wants to be treated poorly. I understand that nobody wants to be shamed. This woman is shaming herself. That is a shameful fucking picture. That is convincing people that she is perfectly okay. Look at this picture of a 13-year-old boy that just passed away from an injection, shall we say. My point is, look at this 13-year-old child. That is the picture of ill health. The problem with the first picture is that it makes it seem like the second picture is not a fucking problem. People say that obesity isn't contagious. Explain childhood obesity then. Explain it, because our genes haven't changed that much in the last 20 years, people. This is just fact. If me stating fact to all of you upsets you, you bitches got work to do. Just for real. You weak-ass motherfuckers have work to do. If me stating that obesity is unhealthy for you hurts you to the point where you just can't stand me, that doesn't change anything, because it's still fucking true at all. You can be pissed at the messenger. You can be pissed at the actual fucking message. You can be pissed at all of it. It doesn't change the fact it's fucking true. The woman in that picture is sick. She's sickly. She's dying daily at a much faster rate than anybody else dies. She is not taking her health seriously. She is not taking people seriously. She's not taking other people's health seriously because she's influencing people to be in an ill health state. She is not taking society seriously, because the more she stays in ill health, the more she's going to be accessing the healthcare system, the more food she's going to be eating, the harder she is on the environment, because the more food she eats, the more production of food we need, the more carbon signature. It is unhealthy to be that big. It is unhealthy to consume twice the calories that a normal person should in a day. And that woman is consuming at least twice the calories she should in a day in order to stay that fucking size. It's fact. It's real. Unless she has some sort of massively serious metabolic disorder, which I'm sure they would disclose, And even then, it's not that stage of morbid obesity. It's not that stage of morbid obesity. That woman's waist to height ratio is probably one. That is very sickly. This woman will need help with her acts of daily living early in her life compared to other people. She will probably need acts of daily living help in her 40s because she's not going to be able to be mobile if she and she's not going to be. If you Back to the 13-year-old boy picture. If you're that obese at 13 years old, that much visceral fat, that much man breast tissue because of obesity, when you're 13 years old, you are not going to live a long, happy, healthy life. That child is doomed to an early, painful fucking death unless shit changes. I'm sorry if that upsets you. I'm sorry if being real upsets you. I'm sorry if actual real facts upsets you. But you motherfuckers got some work to do. You need to get there. If the facts about your health upset you, you have fucking work to do. How does other people have work to do to accept your state of fucking ill health when we live in a society that literally just got shut down for a year and a half because we had so many sickly people? Fuck all you motherfuckers. I get it, you have eating disorders. I've got a fucking eating disorder. I know it's hard. Trust me, I fucking get that shit. I'm a binge eater. I'll always be a binge eater. I consider myself that, and I take steps to get myself fucking healthy and to keep myself fucking healthy. You know why? Because I don't want my wife to have to wipe my ass when I'm fucking 60. That's why. What the fuck, people? I understand you guys are deep in your fucking feels. Deep in your fucking feels. And that's all that seems to fucking matter. But reality is going to reach up and slap the fuck out of a lot of you motherfuckers very soon. You cannot just keep getting fatter and fatter and fatter and think it's not going to fucking do nothing to you. You're developing cancer at higher rates. If obesity was not bad for you, how the fuck do we know that 13 different types of cancer are more prevalent with obesity than smoking? Like, there's warning labels on smoking packages, on cigarette packages. There's warning labels that it causes cancer. But obesity causes 13 types of cancer at a higher rate than smoking. Like, you folks trying to say it's fucking healthy is disgustingly ridiculous. It's like the suspension of reality is just ridiculous. It's so sickening. Like, you're hurting yourselves, you're hurting others. Like, I get it that you don't like to hear it, and you can call me whatever the fuck you want, but that's the thing. All you motherfuckers that get pissed at me, you can't say it's not true. You just get pissed at me. And I'm okay with that because I don't do this for you motherfuckers to be, all happy with me and like me. I don't say shit just for, clicks and likes and shit like that. Oftentimes I say shit that I know is going to get the fucking channel suppressed. Oftentimes I say shit that I know is going to not be great for my side of shit because people aren't ready to hear the fucking truth about themselves and they get so fucking in their feelings that some dude saying facts about their fucking physical state and trying to encourage them to fucking get healthy for their own health and their family's health and to be around for their grandchildren and shit like that. Somehow that upsets you bitches? Fuck all you motherfuckers. I don't, like, that's the thing. I know that we are helping people. I want to help you motherfuckers. But you've got to fucking get there. You can't keep denying that this shit is bad for you when we know it's bad for you. If you're an adult and you're actually trying to say that obesity isn't bad for you, you're acting like a fucking kindergartner. You're acting like you live in a fucking fairy tale world. You're acting like you're playing make believe. Stop it. At least admit to yourself that it's bad for you and bad for the environment and bad for the fucking country and bad for society and bad for the healthcare system. At least admit it. Because then, if you admit it and then don't do anything about it, you'll be seen for who the fuck you actually are. Somebody that doesn't give a fuck about anybody else but themselves. That's the fucking truth. You need to accept that shit. That's right. You only care about yourself. If all you care about is somebody making sure that you're found sexy or beautiful, even when you're obese, if that's your biggest concern, you're just a selfish person. You're selfish as fuck. Unfucking believably selfish. You're willing to just put a fucking dangerous ass message that obesity is not actually fucking dangerous for people out there to make yourselves feel better, to make yourselves feel okay with how you've totaled your fucking bodies. And that may hurt a lot of you, but that's the fucking truth. And speaking as a former morbidly obese person, I'll fucking tell you if nobody else fucking will. That's for fucking sure. I don't do this to be liked. That's the fucking best part about this shit. You can fucking hate me all you want. You can't say it's not fucking true. Goddamn.